Hi, so we're looking at second stage of preparation. So once your syllabus is over, what do you need to do with regards to DLR? Which areas you need to improve? That is the focus of this particular session. So what is the second stage we talk about? Second stage is basically when you talk about is first stage is where you talk about syllabus. So you're completing the syllabus. Second stage is beyond the syllabus when you look at mock and strategy and revision and improvement. So a lot of people know where to study the syllabus from. They pick up the books and study and that's it. But then once the syllabus gets over, they are clueless in terms of what they need to do. Right? So this is where the second stage comes. So we'll start with DILR, where this video is purely focused on DILR. What needs to be worked on? So one is you need to be familiar with various sets, because the sets that come in the exam is quite different from what has come in the books. Second, important is selection of question. Third, the process, the way you solve. I mean, you need to keep on improving that. Fourth, you need to like reduce the time as far as possible, because each set of DILR could take a longer time. Then the way you solve, the methods that you use to solve is important. Calculations and thinking ability. So these are the different things that you need to work on in the second stage of preparation. Let's look at each thing and try to figure out what you need to do in each stage. Start with familiarity. Familiarity is important because the questions in the exam that comes in DILR is quite different every year. I mean, you may go to the past questions, but the next year questions will be different. And the more type of questions you're familiar with, the better it is, because that sort of question could be a little familiar with you, to you. I mean, you may not have the same question, but the familiarity will improve with better practice. So that means the idea is basically whatever sets in the books are very different from what comes in the exam, as I said. So every year the type is considerably different from what it is before. I mean, one day year you had all 8 sets of logic which are very different. Some year you will have a few DI sets, one few logic sets. So they're completely different on that. So solving different kind of sets will help in improve familiarity. So practice. And how do you practice? It makes sense to practice from the mocks of different classes, especially the top classes like IMS, Time, CL. So they will have good questions which are there. You can pick up questions from there and solve. Maybe this year, maybe last year, last 2-3 years ka papers, pick up and try to solve. And that helps you to become familiar with the particular sets, different kind of sets, right? Next, selection of question. Selection in DILR is important because of the, for a tough sum, it is, takes a very long time to solve. Okay, because any, you pick up a wrong set, you will waste a lot of time, 15-20 minutes just on a wrong set. And if you pick up an easy set, you'll get the answer quickly. And that's a huge difference with regards to time. So every time you practice, I mean, that selection has to improve in practice. Every time you practice, spend at least 2 minutes on each set, whether you, and identifying whether the sets are easy, medium, or tough. 2 minutes per set. Okay, that you need to do in practice. Remember, everything that you work on should start with practice and then with a mock. That's what it helps. Okay. After solving, once you identify, okay, I took this set as easy and I solved it. Oh, but I found it tough. So why was the selection wrong? Go back and check out. Find out the parameters on which you have decided the set is easy or tough. And check out whether your parameters are right and why did your selection went wrong. Right? So write down the parameters of selection and revisit them. I mean, keep on finding out that is there different, I need to change it. Do I need to add something? Do I need to remove something in the parameters? So keep on looking at the parameters and trying to work on the parameters of selection. Important to select sets. If you select 2 easy sets, and there are 2 easy sets in the exam. If you select 2 easy sets in the exam and solve it all correct, you get 80% right, approximately. So learn to select sets. Process of solving. Next, you need to work on the process. What is the process we are talking about? It is the way you read the data. I mean, there are sometimes people take twice to read the data. Some people even take 3 times to read the data. It's a waste of time. Why can't we read the data once, that's it, and understand what is given to you? Then how to note down the data? Do I put a proper table first of all? Or do I just put a data and then I put a table? How do I know what table to be drawn? So how to note down the data also is important. Where to start from? I know the data, I know things. Now where do I start from? There's no direct starting process in a lot of times. You need to work on which is the starting place and how to go about proceeding. And if I'm stuck, what do I do? Should I leave it? Should I go back and read the set? What do I do? The process has to be clear so that I don't waste time and not knowing what to do. I need to know how to and what to do every time when I'm following and solving a set. Right? Make note. Now, one of the key things that is determining is how to start different sets. So whenever you come across a set and you start with a set, make a note of how do you start different types of sets. with this type of sets, I will solve this way, start with this way. Because a lot of people don't know, no clue of how to start. They put the data down, but there's no clue of how to start. So figure out, write down your data. Okay, these type of set, this is how to start. This type of set, this is how to start. You come across a new way of starting, put it down. So look at how to start. That becomes important. Time. Each set of DILR set takes a lot of time. Like unlike quant, then time taken per question is less. But for DILR, the time taken per set is long. So that means there's always ways to improve on your time. Okay. So try to reduce. First time where you can reduce is to reduce the time of identifying questions. Ideal time should not be more than 1 to 2 minutes. I analyze my students' mock and I realize some of them even take 3 or 4 minutes per test to identify whether it's easy or tough. Doesn't make sense. Try to reduce time in identifying question. It'll help. So ideal time maximum 1 to 2 minutes is what is recommended. Now once you have solved, okay, a set, go back and check where you wasted a lot of time. Have you wasted a lot of time in reading a set, understanding the set, putting down the data, starting the set, solving the set? So there are different stages of solving a more or less one question. So where have you wasted a lot of time? And try to find ways to reduce that time. So the one very simple example I give you, I've seen a lot of people wasting time reading the set 2 or 3 times. Is it possible that you read it once, put down the data and finish up the set? I save time on reading it second time and third time. That's one way of reading. So if you're good at reading, I'm sure you'll be able to read it once and able to understand a set. It'll require a little bit of practice, but see if you can reduce time in reading or any stage that is there in your DILR sets. Methods. So every set in DILR, most of the sets in DILR can be solved in multiple ways. I mean, it is the LR sets, they have different approaches of solving it. It is important to try to find the optimum way to solve. For example, there's a matrix sum, which are very common, which are there. There's a tick cross method, which is there, but if I find that a little longer. And there's also one where you form columns and try to get the answer. The forming columns is much faster than tick cross method. But people normally use tick cross method because that is what is given in the books. So try to form and figure out better ways of solving. Normally, in most of the cases, what methods are given in the books may not be a good and optimal method. So you need to reformulate your methods, reformulate the ways of solving and try to improve on that. Every sum that you solve, try to have an alternate approach. Alternate approach also helps you to give flexibility. So tomorrow you have a sum in the exam, I can figure out which approach is right, which approach is wrong. If one approach doesn't work, I can try the next approach. It helps. So look at alternate approach of solving the same sum. You may not get an alternate approach for every set, but the fact that you try will help you to improve. Calculations. I mean, like in quant, in calculations helps you to save time. So focus on calculation. Same thing, improve on your mental calculation. Do simple mental calculations every time. Two-digit calculation like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division is sufficient. In DI, you normally do have big calculations, but you can always approximate them to two-digit calculations and try to solve. If possible, in DI specifically, learn approximation. Approximation is the key to improve in DI at least. So focus on learning how to approximate values and try to get the answer. So when you do two-digit calculation mentally, you also approximate and see how close or far your answers are from the actual answer. And factorize 3 to 4-digit numbers. It's the same like what I talked about quant. That this is how you practice calculations regularly. Try to be good and fast at calculations. Improving thinking ability. Because in DILR, you have every time a new type of sets. If you try to improve your thinking ability, it helps. And how do you improve your thinking ability? Try solving varied kind of puzzles. Because puzzles make you think in a different kind of way. One of the very common thing is Sudoku. I mean, a lot of good students solve Sudoku. Because Sudoku helps you to put down the data properly and solve it systematically. Also, there are a lot of sums in logic which are directly related to Sudoku. So Sudoku helps them solve Karakuro, Hirato, different kind of puzzles. You can also search logical puzzles online. I mean, you can do that. Or you can look at puzzle book. Actually, I remember one quant question that came in the exam which was directly from a puzzle book which came in. Quant and puzzle book, yes, but that comes. So trying to solve a lot of puzzles, puzzle books, etc. will help you to develop your ability to solve and think. That's more important. Because if a different kind of sums come in the exam, what will save your day is your thinking ability. And developing thinking ability is very important. Keep practicing. Practice. No two ways beyond practice. Don't keep pressure on yourself to solve a set within time. You can give maximum time. Say let's say 10 minutes or 20 minutes. If I get the set, fine. If I don't get the set, I'll see the solution. That is fine. There's no point wasting hours and hours on one individual set. That's a waste of time. Right? But don't pressurize yourself, because the best methods come when you're free of your mind and you're relaxed. So when practice, don't try to set a time limit on solving a set. Try to solve a set with a relaxed mind and see if you can get the answer. Okay. Good questions, as I said, are from current mocks or past mocks. So IMS and CL have good set of questions that you can pick up from there and then try to solve, practice from there. Before starting any set, as I said earlier also, spend 2 minutes on identification. It's very important. 2 minutes on identification before you solve. After every set, check your process. Will you follow the process that you had planned? Whatever process you had followed. Okay, did it go smoothly or did you have a problem in that? Search for alternate sum after every sum. I mean, you may not get it, but just thinking about it helps. Give enough time. Don't focus on quantity, focus on quality. Okay, give enough time for each set. I mean, don't let a rush thing matter. Learn. This is learning. Practice is a learning experience. You rush in your mocks, but right now, try to learn the methods, and this learning will help you better. And you can solve 2 to 8 sets every day based on your strength. If your strength, you can solve less sets, 2 sets per day is sufficient. If it's a weakness, you can solve 4 or 5 sets. 8 is too much. Maybe 4 or 5 sets are enough, but depends on how weak or how strong you are. You can decide on your practice. I put 8 because one mock has 8 sets. If you plan to solve one complete mock in a day without a time limit, you will have to solve 8 sets as such. But anyway, decide on the amount you want to practice every day. Right? And next, have a friend or a group of friends whom you can discuss methods with. Okay, it helps, because maybe they have a different perspective from what you have, and that could help you to understand better. Hope this helps you to understand how to go about DR in a second stage of preparation. Practice. Focus on improvement. Focus on which areas of improvement is what I've tried to tell you. Work on that, and that should help you. Thank you.